Gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these people to join together in holy matrimony. We know that marriage is honored and is an honorable esteem. It's instituted of God, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, declared by St. Paul to be honorable among all men. It is not therefore to be entered into without holy advice, nor to be lightly, but reverently, soberly, and advisedly, and in the fear of God. Let us therefore under seriousness and of this act invoke divine presence upon this occasion. Let us pray, Almighty God, King Eternal, from whom receiving all power and dominion, both in heaven and on earth, we humbly beseech thee to look with favor upon thy servant, this man and this woman. We ask that you be the honored guest at this wedding, that you would turn the water into wine, wine of joy, that you would grant unto them the assurance that they have been brought together by the providence, so that they may be truly and eternally joined together by the Holy Ghost. We pray through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. This is a charge for both of you. I now charge you both that you stand in the presence of God to remember that true love and faithful observance of your marriage vows are required as a foundation of a successful marriage. To vow and require the foundation that be established, be happy, and enduring home. Without these, you cannot really have a successful marriage. In the home which you will endure or endeavor to establish will be a vain effort. Keep the solemn vows you are about to make. Live with tender consideration for each other. Conduct your lives in honesty and in truth, and your marriage will last. Your home will be lasting. This commitment to marriage will be a blessing to you and will be a blessing to others. This should be remembered as you now desire to be united in holy living. Anthony, I'd like you to repeat after me. So I would say to you, Anthony, do you take this woman to be your wedded wife? And do you earnestly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for her alone, you will perform unto her all the respect that a husband owes to his wife, until God by death shall separate you. Fortress, do you take this man to be your wedded husband? And do you earnestly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love him, comfort him, honor and obey him in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for him, will perform unto him all the duties that a wife owes to her husband, and to God by death shall separate you from this happy. And I want everyone to know that it said obey for the woman. It didn't say obey for the man. And that is something for each one of us to learn. In the marriage vows, you do not put what you want in the vows. The vows are to be followed as they are stated. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. I don't write the vows, I follow the vows. I believe that we should follow the vows as they are written. Now, who gave this woman?
I do.
This is the Father. Therefore, since it is agreement, Anthony and Portus, husband and wife. If you join right hand and repeat after me. Join right hand. Join right hand. Put your right hand together. Your right hand is together.
Perfect.
Your right hand.
Okay. Right
hand.
There you go. Sign the inward and spiritual grace. It signifies to all the uniting of this man and this woman in holy matrimony in the church of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We ask, Lord, that you would bless these rings, those who wear them. Let them abide in you and in your peace. Let them continue in your faith for our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. As much Anthony Fortress have been centered together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and there to have pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands and given and received the ring, and pronounced that they are husband right together, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, those whom God has joined together, and no man but the Son. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Most gracious Father, we thank you. We thank you for these two that you have joined together. We ask that you would look upon them again and build them in your most gracious blessing. Touch them in every way. Bless their home. Bless their families in every way. And Lord God, we should continue to give you praise, glory, and honor. In Jesus' name, amen.